Emma, come in. Sit down. How are you?
Fine.
Good. And the office? Things are well?
Yes.
Good. Good. I wanted to talk to you about Darren Glenister. Okay. Do you know Darren?
Yes, he works in my office.
Would you say that by your definition, Darren is a colleague?
Yes.
But not a friend?
I don't mean to be rude, but I don't have to tell you who my friends are, do I? There's nothing in the contract about that.
No. I mean, you're quite right, of course. I was just making conversation.
I see.
It's just that Darren has come to see me, and he told me you went out for dinner.
Has he?
Yes. Would you like to tell me anything?
I don't know why Darren has told you that we went out for dinner.
He said that he thought it was romantic. He's quite agitated about it. He's given me a few details to discuss with you.
Okay.
Apparently there was a candle on the table.
Is that it?
Emma, let me finish. Let me finish. He said there was a substantial amount of eye contact and that on a number of occasions you touched his arm. He goes on. Later on in the evening, when you left the club and got into the taxi, you put your hand on his inner thigh, which caused him to become aroused. You kissed him on the cheek, which then became mouth-to-mouth kissing. You put your tongue in his mouth.
Okay, we went back to mine where we had sex, and we've been seeing each other for a week.
A week?
Yes.
But you've waited until now to inform us.
Because we wanted to be certain of the definition of our relationship.
I see.
Is it all okay now that I've told you?
And how do you find the sex?
I'm sorry?
The sex. Would you describe it as good? You see, Emma, we need to know what kind of relationship you're having. A loving relationship with little or no sex can create an entirely different office dynamic than a couple in a relationship having enjoyable and regular sex.
It was good.
Darren has said excellent. Can we compromise and say very good?
Yes.
Okay. I'll put that to Darren to confirm. And how many times a week have you had sex?
4.
Darren has said 5.
Oh, you must be counting something else.
What?
I beat him off.
Right. Yes. Judging by what you have told us and the scores produced from that information, Darren will be relocated to Richmond.
That's miles away.
It's only 13 miles away, company policy. Thank you, Emma.
Yes.
Sit down, how are you?
Okay.
And little Stephen, is it? Things went well? The birth? You don't have to tell me. I'm just making small talk.
Yes, everything went fine, thank you. Darren sees Stephen every week.
So, there's nothing happening that you feel you should tell me?
No, we don't talk at all. Don't worry.
Emma, the thing is, the company have been looking at yours and Darren's situation, and they've concluded that your relationship can still be characterised as partly sexual.
But it's not, we don't. We stopped for you because you told us.
Emma, let me finish. You see, a presence of a child produced through sex means that this will not change. Darren is the father of your son. And as long as this son continues to live...
As long as he continues to live.
What?
What are you saying?
We don't want to lose you. Either of you. So, we're going to relocate Darren to Kiev.
Kiev?
Kiev.
Where's Kiev?
The Ukraine, near Russia.
But Darren won't be able to get to see his son.
That's not the company's concern. That is a private matter.
Is that all you want? Can you go now?
Yes! Do come to me if you have any problems. Emma, sit down. What's this? Oh.
You wanted to see it?
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Emma. I'll pass this on. Now, it turns out, I'm afraid Darren has decided to stay in Kiev.
What?
He said that he has nothing to come back for, which I don't agree with. It's a real pain.
But I've given you this, what you said you needed. Why don't you just order him?
We're not an army, Emma. I didn't give out orders.
Well, I can go there now then. Now that you've got what you needed, I can be relocated. I can move
Emma,
to Kiev.
Emma, we don't need you in Kiev. We need you here. We can't just relocate people for fun.
I have nothing here. My baby is dead. Do you care?
You have excellent prospects.
Do you care about me at all?
Yes. We have a duty of care for all of our employees. I can give you a leaflet.
I can't leave this company. Like you said, I wouldn't get another job.
No.
So that would be the end. Do you care? Do you bleed?
Are you all right?
Actually, I'm not sure.
Not sure of what?
That you bleed.